Americans seem lost over the EU referendum, or Brexit for short.
Claire Sebastian explains why this may or may not affect people's finances.
Brexit? Sounds like a store.
In the business capital of the world, New York City,
I have no idea.
There's some confusion around the word Brexit.
I thought it was like a breath mint or something.
I don't know. A watch company? It's actually a British exit from the European Union.
Okay.
Do you think that's something you should care about?
No.
The message on Wall Street, it's time to start caring.
It absolutely will have an impact on Americans' 401ks and their other investments.
The threat of Brexit is already having an impact. It's one of the reasons for current market volatility.
There's definitely fear.
Even a Fed rate rise on hold.
It was one of the factors.
This is a tsunami. This is China melting down. This is Lehman going out of business, in my opinion.
It's not the first dire warning. The US president has said trade with the UK could suffer. Last year, that was worth $56 billion to US businesses.
Our focus is in negotiating with a big bloc, the European Union, to get a trade agreement done. And UK is going to be in the back of the queue.
The more optimistic in New York's banking community say that is premature.
We're not going to turn around to the UK and say, no, you can't bring Jaguars in. So what we're going to do is extend out any trade relationships until we figure out a new workout process.
3,500 miles from the UK, it is hard to imagine what Brexit would feel like. One U.S. talk show host used another British export to explain it.
Look at it this way. When Zayn left, One Direction was okay. But if Harry leaves, that's it. It's over.
That warning still lost on some New Yorkers.
Is it like a word scramble thing?
A word scramble for sure. An economic scramble for the U.S. Well, it depends who you ask. Claire Sebastian, CNN Money, New York.
All right, with more now on how Brexit could affect your money, financial advisor Lori Itkin joining us now with how we should prepare if the UK votes to get out. We've seen the market go this way and that way based on the polls coming out of England. What does it all mean?
Good morning, Roel. Well, we've had so much volatility in the stock market. Last week, we saw US stocks and global stocks falling in anticipation of the Britain leaving the European Union. And then yesterday morning, the stock market opened with a huge bang, the biggest increase we've seen in months, because the polls now show that UK voters are leaning towards voting to stay in the EU.
And they've been part of the EU for over 40 years, right? So
that
would be a big drastic change.
It would be a huge change. And basically, I mean, why some of the voters want to leave the EU is we've seen, just like in this country, immigration is a huge issue over there. And because the countries are all part of the EU, people can move freely from country to country.
Right.
And therefore, a lot of people are coming in. They want to be in the UK to get jobs because they're great, the salaries and benefits. And just like, you know, Donald Trump over here in the U.S. is saying we can't keep having all this uncontrolled immigration. There are a lot of voters in the U.K. that feel the same way.
I mean, and we saw it with the government official who was, in essence, assassinated by a person who was yelling that we need to keep Britain. That had to do with this and the passions that are overflowing there.
It did. This is a huge issue. It's a tragedy what happened, and it's become very politicized. And the whole issue that we, though, in the U.S. need to care about, we all have retirement accounts, and the volatility, we are going to see the market go up and down over the next few days until that vote. And if I predict that if the U.K. decides to leave the EU, we are going to see a terrible crash in the stocks, and people are then going to go and put their money in bonds and gold. Those are the safe haven assets. But if we stay, if they vote to stay in the EU, I think the market's going to just be fine. People don't like change.
Yeah, I know we call it the market, but it's really, these are just people. These are people emotions and the volatility you mentioned. It's so delicate. We see, when China's having their issues, the market has a huge effect. And now we're talking about Britain leaving the EU, and that's having a huge effect. If the leavers, as they're called, if the leavers win on Thursday, what should we do to prepare?
Well, you know, we're not going to really know till the vote comes out. But I think if we wake up Friday and we see that they've voted to leave, I think stocks are going to take a huge hit. But it may be an opportunity to buy some good stocks on sale. And just know that over time, the stock market will rebound. We may see, though, that interest rates in this country will stay low. Mm. You know, the Federal Reserve is looking at raising interest rates, and they will not raise interest rates if there is a global economic turmoil to deal with.
Here's a question. Okay, so if the stayers, I know it's unusual for the way that we speak here versus England, but they have the leavers, they have the stayers. Let's say the stayers win, according to the polls. What changes will we see, or is it going to be business as usual and it's like nothing happened?
It'll be business as usual, and that's just the same as it's a prediction for our U.S. Right. election here. If Hillary Clinton wins, I think we're going to see the stock market, everything business as usual. Mm-hmm. But if Donald Trump wins, oh, talk about volatility in the stock market. Sure. He's unpredictable, and investors do not like that.
Okay, I don't even know if you would. Let's say once the election is over, can they come back around, or how often would they want to propose that they leave the EU?
Oh, I honestly, this is such a big deal. I think it would be very difficult to put that rabbit back in the hat.
Exactly, exactly. Well, we'll see. Thursday is going to be a big day.
It is.
To say the least. We'll see what happens. All right, Lori Itkin, we thank you for your expertise as always.
Thank you, Roel.
Thanks, Lori.